So friends, what is the mentoring exactly? So we are talking about in detail.
For the purpose of this program, mentoring will be defined as a process of arrange the experienced individuals to provide the guidance and advice that will be helped to develop the career of a mentees located to them. Mentoring is defined as a number of ways. Mentoring relationship is a relationship between two or more people, whether formalized or not. Where the relationship has a specific purpose, the relationship is a reciprocal and both parties benefited, even though the different way. The mentor and mentee and this relationship is a dynamic with the different stage and or the different phases. Each mentor and mentee's relationship is unique, although there are many certain general characteristics in the mentee and mentor relationship. This relationship is translate duty, obligation of often involves the coaching, networking, sponsoring, career counseling. From the above definition, it is evident that mentoring is a learning partnership that is co-created by two parties, namely the mentee and mentor. So definition highlights some important characteristics of this mentoring. This definition highlights some important characteristics. Mentoring relationship is a dynamic form as it is a focus on the growth and knowledge transfer. It is a mutual relationship with the suggested and commitment to the relationship to both bodies. It is learning partnership in which mentor and mentee are learning and growing. The relationship takes a place within the context of the working environment. The mentor is wise, professional, obligant. The mentor is focused on the helping the mentee to develop his or her potential. The mentor is not only a direct supervisor, he is playing a role of mentor. The mentee is developed in the same specific capacity. In other words, we can say that clear purpose and focus for the development through the mentoring. Remember one thing, mentoring is not about the being sponsored for the promotion. This is the in-depth concept of related to the student development. The role of mentor is not simply provide the guidance and advice on how accomplish the certain task successfully. The mentor primary role is that to provide the psychological support and fostering the mentee's visibility. The role of the mentee is to accept the responsibility for his or her own growth and to see the feedback from the mentor as well as an opportunity to grow and improve their skills. Mentoring benefits to mentee. Yes, mentoring is very powerful tool. It can be have a many benefits. For this reason, it requires much planning, efforts, energy, which should be directed towards to attain the specific benefit for students, teachers, and their organization. Just we saw what the coaching means. Is there any difference? Yes, there is the quite difference in that. The systematically planned and direct guidance of an individual or a group of individuals by coaching to learn and develop specific skills that are the applied to implemented. From this, it is clear that coaching is a form of on-the-job training. In order to be a good mentor, one must already to be a good coach. Well, we see this with the help of some points. So what are the points is that coaching and mentoring, what is the difference between that? We are going to see with the some points. Coaching means there is a usually to direct related to the manager, but mentoring is directly related to the mentor, but it's indirectly working with the student's life. In coaching, maintained by the performance appraisal, in mentoring, it is the continuous process. Coaching is training focused and mentoring is development focused. Coaching is as appointed, but in mentoring, as a mentor is nominated or a volunteer he is working. Coaching is occur the job, but in mentoring, occur off the job. These are the different kind of points. Coaching is a training focused, but mentor is the development focus. In coaching, goals, objective and task are nominally not documented, but in mentoring, mentor need to documentation of a goals, objective and different kind of a task. After knowing coaching and mentoring, what is the difference between the counseling and mentoring? In this point, we are going to discuss something. So basically, we are talking about the counseling. As per our point, we are talking counseling. In generally, counselors are trained to diagnose, to help the client with the emotional problems. And the mentor is a wise and trusted guide as an advisor. The advisor mentee is sharing their experiences by being a mentee up to the marks. Means what? So coaching aims to achieve, empower, enhancement today, whereas a mentoring aims to achieve performance and empowerment tomorrow. Counseling, this can be enable the client to focus on the feeling, experiences or behavior with goal of facilitating positive changes. Do you think there are some principles regarding to mentoring? Yes, of course. There are the some principles regarding the mentoring. What is that? So that mentoring is a journey towards the empowerment, not only through the transfer of a knowledge, but through the commitment of a relationship. It is about the relationship building to facilitate the growth on different level, like establish a positive personal relationship. Once a positive personal relationship is developed, it is much easier to realize the problems of a student. And friends, it's very important to realize the problems of the students. Next point, we can say that the trust and respect must be established. Regular and interaction. This is the vice versa dependent upon the mentor and mentee, and regular interaction and a constant support are important in many mentoring relationship. Next one, help mentees to develop academic and life skills. Work to accomplish specific goals. For example, the tutoring, the assessment on the homework, assignment, or a peer advising about the best use of the free time. So we, as a mentor, help to mentees to develop the academic and the life skill. When and where appropriate, emphasis life management skills, such as the decision making, goal setting, time management, dealing with the conflict, value certification, and skills for coping with the stress and fear. Assist the mentees in accessing the academic and higher education resources. Friends, this is very important to how to help as a mentor to use the different kind of resources to their development. So assisting them is very important to provide the information, or better yet, help your mentees to find the information about academic resources like the faculty, staff, academic support, services, student organization, different kind of needs, whatever the student needs. Assist the mentees in learning how to assess and use these resources. It's very important because first stage of student is very, very crucial time. They didn't know about anything about their atmosphere. So that's why mentor's role is to assess them properly. Enhance your mentee's ability to interact comfortably and productively with the different kind of people, groups from the diverse national, ethical, cultural and socio-economic backgrounds. Because students comes different part and they are comes together to discussion and the education. But they still face a lot of problems. So some are belief, we always know that we are not all the same. It is important to acknowledge and understand, not ignore our differences. We need to learn how to use our differences as a resources for our and others' growth. So respectively, our differences is necessary but not sufficient. We need to know how to negotiate our differences in a way that produce a new understanding and insight. Some are holds a particular phenomena like the or stereotypes
attitude about one's own group or other groups. They take a special care as a mentor. As a mentor, you are not to ignore, consciously or unconsciously, promote your own views, values of your mentee's point of view. Work at understanding and critically examine your own perspective. That is also very important. Next point which we can discuss, like the mentor's empowerment. So mentor's empowerment, rather than they enable their mentees, empowerment is using giving a mentee hope and building the confidence that he or she can actually get it right with or without mentor. So mentor do not just provide an answer and solution to their mentees' questions or a problem or obstacles, because they are not used to that all answers, but we have to guide only how to find out the solution. Means we are going to create an atmosphere they can able to find out their own self. So mentor share their basic components of the learning and competency of a learning, and thereby encouraging their mentees to explore themselves, grow and generate their own ideas and solutions. This process encourages the maturity, realization and independence within the mentees. So mentor encourage and guide the process of the reflecting on their own action. That is also a very important principle. The latter facilitates and internalizations of a learning to be held from the particular vendors. For example, to promote the skill and knowledge of a transfer. Creating the capacity for the duplication of a knowledge and skills is very important. Next point which you can say that this is the very important principle, like enhance the leadership capacity among the mentees. So mentoring is are a core components. So provide the opportunity to take their own decision, lead the groups, mentor their peer groups. Yes friends, this is very important to enhance the leadership in your mentees. Reinforce learning and development. Mentoring joined with the training increase the application of a knowledge and skills within the student. It is very important in mentor's role. The main principle is ensure that the mentee has a clear understanding what to expect and where mentee is going. The mentor prepared to the kind of support to provide the mentee with during the various stages of a growth process.